Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Siddharth Pariyar and today we are going to learn about PC Hardware Trainer Kit and its order code is 10906. So in this apparatus, we will learn about its application, its body parts and its working. The purpose of the apparatus will be to understand the working of components of a desktop computer individually and together with other components. So now we will be opening the PC Hardware Trainer Kit and be seeing the different components inside the kit. As you can see, this is the main board consisting of a power switch, a CPU on and off switch, a reset switch which can be used to reset or restart the computer, a HDD LED. This is the hard disk drive or SSD solid state drive which can be used as a secondary storage. This is the motherboard in which all the components are connected. This is the multimedia computer trainer board where you can attach different components based on your requirement into the motherboard. This is the DVD reader and this is the power supply. This is the monitor which can be connected to the motherboard via a VGA connector. This is the keyboard. This is the mouse. These both components have PS2 connectors as you can see here. As you can see, we have connected the monitor to the motherboard via the VGA cable from here to the back of the monitor. We have connected the mouse and the keyboard through the PS2 connectors. The green connector is for mouse and the purple connector is for keyboard. Now we can start turning on our system. You have to connect the monitor and the kit to the AC main supply. After that, you have to turn on the main power switch. When you turn on, the green LED in the motherboard will glow, which indicates that the motherboard has started receiving power. After that, you have to turn on the CPU on switch, which will start the CPU, which will give supply to the motherboard, and the CPU will start with the CPU fan. As you can see, our system has now turned on and the monitor will display contents. Now you can see the motherboard has loaded the operating system from the hard disk. Now you can resume operating your computer. Now we are going to observe the tools and work area in the PC Hardware Trainer Kit. This is the RAM, this is the heat sink, this is the CPU fan, below there is the CPU, these are PCIe slots, this is the power supply, this is the ribbon connectors which are used to connect the hard drives as well as the DVD drives to the motherboard. These are 4 wire connectors which are used to give power supply to the motherboard via the power supply. Now we will understand about CPU. CPU is the acronym for Central Processing Unit. CPU is responsible for handling all the operations that are performed across a computer. It mainly has 2 parts, ALU and CU. ALU means arithmetic logic units which is responsible for performing all the arithmetic operations, and the control unit CU is responsible for handling the successful data transfer from ALU to the motherboard and to different parts of the computer. To get a glimpse of the CPU, we have to remove the cooler fan and then we will take out the CPU from the socket. With the help of a screwdriver, you can unscrew these 4 nuts and then you can remove the CPU fan. After removing the CPU fan, you can see there is a socket and inside the socket there is CPU. So now removing this pin, we can remove the CPU. As you can see, I have opened the socket. Now this is the CPU, which is the master chip inside the computer. We will remove this chip and take a glimpse of this. As you can see, this is a CPU. It has many pins which are of golden color, which serve different purposes. This is the upper look of the CPU. As you can see, this is thermal paste applied on the CPU. As you can see, this is the CPU. The backside of CPU is like this. The CPU has multiple golden colored pins which serve different purposes. As you can see, I have now again placed the CPU and the cooler above the CPU. Now we will again power on our system and understand the upcoming experiment. Now, this is the CMOS battery, which is responsible for running the clock in the computer. When the computer is on, nothing gets supplied, but the clock keeps running because of the CMOS battery. As you can see, I have removed the CMOS battery from the socket. You can place it again back into the socket. Now we are going to learn about the secondary storage, that is the hard disk drive. Hard drive is responsible for storing our files and other things into the computer. It is different from the primary storage, that is the RAM, which stands for random access memory. All the instructions that are executed by the CPU are stored in the RAM chip, and the component and the files that are not currently accessed but they are important are stored in the secondary storage. The operating system files are also stored in this storage. If you want to replace the secondary storage, you can replace it easily by removing just these two wires. These two wires are, first is the power connector and second is the SATA cable, which is used to access the contents of the hard drive. As you can see, I have removed the SATA cable, which stands for serial ATA connector, and the power cable. When you remove these two cables, you can replace the hard drive and you can again connect it to the mother. As you can see, I have connected the hard drive. Now we are going to proceed with powering on our system and seeing how we can create and delete partitions in the hard disk. Now we will see how to create and delete partitions in a hard disk. Partitions are used to separate a single hard disk storage into two or three virtual spaces so that the important files of different categories can be separated with each other. To see how many partitions are there in the disk, you have to open run and then type diskmanagement.msc. It will open the disk management window, which will show you the different partitions inside the hard disk. You just have to type diskmgmt.msc, which stands for diskmanagement.microsoft service. It will open the window. A window like this will appear on your monitor, which will show you the different partitions inside the hard disk. From here, you can shrink the size of one partition. You can create a new partition, and if you want to delete an existing partition, you can also delete it from here. Now, if you want to format a partition or a disk, you can just right click on the disk and you can select format. After that, a format window will appear, which will ask you these settings. You have to keep the file system as NTFS, and if you want to do a fast formatting, you can click on quick format, and if you want a full format which fully empties the disk, you can uncheck the quick format option and then you can start. It will format the disk. Now, when you store different types of things or files or documents in a partition or in a hard disk, the hard disk allocates space to the files by breaking the storage of hard disk into small pieces to allocate the space to the different files. Like, for example, if you have multiple files that are of small size or a single file of very big size, then depending on the amount of files and the size of files, that the computer breaks the storage part of the hard disk into smaller break pieces, which is called fragmentation. Now, fragmentation is not good for the health of hard drive. So, in order to defragment the drive, we are going to need the tool. Now, in order to defragment the drive, we are going to need the tool named disk defragmenter. From here, you can find the disk defragmenter tool. After you open the tool, you can see this window appears. It will show you the name of the partition as well as how much percentage of that partition is defragmented. This window appears. This window will show you what partitions of the disk are fragmented. If you are getting some error in a certain partition or your partition is not working properly, you can use the tool scan disk to scan errors in a particular disk. Now, sometimes when browsing the internet from your PC, you might get viruses inside the computer. Now, these viruses are of different types which can infect the files existing in your computer. So, to ensure that you are running a virus-free computer, you have to install certain type of softwares known as antivirus softwares, which warn you or remove the virus existing in your computers. Now we are going to learn about CD/DVD reader. This is the CD/DVD reader where you can place the CD inside it, and you can access the contents of the CD/DVD from the CD to the from your computer. As you can see, I have opened the CD reader. You can place the CD and then you can again press the button. This slide goes inside and you can see the contents. In some cases, the power supply coming out of the main power supply is not sufficient to run all components of the motherboard. In order to change the power supply, you can easily change the power supply component of the PC just by replacing the power supply. If you are doing multiple amount of tasks at the same time, or you are using a specific task that requires a much larger amount of memory to run, then you can add or replace your RAM with a much more amount of RAM. To do this, you just have to buy the perfect RAMs required for the motherboard, and then you can insert the RAM into one of these RAM sockets. As you can see, there are two slots. One of them is already occupied with a RAM. If you want to add more RAM to your PC, you can add by adding the RAM here in this socket. As you can see, the motherboard already has a RJ45 connector which can be used to connect Ethernet to the motherboard in order to access internet. You can also access internet from your computer via Wi-Fi if you have the wireless NIC, that is wireless network interface card, installed to your computer. You can purchase any NIC from the market and you can insert it into the one of the PCIe Express slots, and then you can access internet wirelessly from your computer via the NIC. PCIe Express slots or PCIe slots, these slots can be used to connect additional peripherals to the motherboard. Like for example, if you want to connect a sound card which is used to output the sound, like connecting a speaker. Or for example, if you want to connect GPU, that is graphics processing unit, to your motherboard to play video games or do other graphics things, then you can connect GPU to the motherboard via the PCIe slot. Now you have already learned all the different components inside a desktop computer and you know the working of all these components. You can also build your own computer from these things. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any queries related to the apparatus, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, you can refer the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, please share and subscribe to our channel.